It's day five of the rescue operations at the landslide hit Wayanad in Kerala. As rescue teams are digging deeper, bodies are surfacing. Their toll has crossed the 350 mark. Kerala forest officials also conducted a heroic operation where they rescued six children. Families, meanwhile, remain shattered, losing their loved ones. Relief and rescue operations continue on day five. Army, NDRF and other rescue teams are at the spot continuing their operations. Many are still here trapped under the debris. Meanwhile, the Kerala Chief Minister has lauded the Forest Department officials after they rescued six children from a tribal settlement in the area in an eight-hour-long operation. Remember, many children have died in the killer landslides in Wayanad. Actor and Honorary Lieutenant Colonel of 122 Infantry Battalion, T.A. Madras, Mohanlal, also fondly known by name of Lalitan, visited the landslide-affected Punchiri Mattam village in Wayanad, bringing hope and support to those affected by the devastating floods.
On our way to the landslide site in Wayanad, and this is the only road that you can use to go to the landslide site. And for the last 2-3 days, this stretch of road, there's been tight regulations in terms of traffic because they do not want unnecessary vehicles to come here, because of course there's a lot of movement of essential vehicles, be it ambulances, be it vehicles carrying equipments for rescue work, be it other essentials. So for that reason, they're not allowing any unnecessary vehicle to come in. And here, these are locals who live just a couple of kilometers away from the landslide site, and everyone, what is very, very heartwarming, even in this time of devastation and tragedy, is how people of Kerala, people of Wayanad are stepping up, in this time of crisis to help in whatever little way possible that they can. And that explains the real spirit of Kerala, especially during times of disaster. Entire state comes together to do whatever little they can to help the distressed people. With video journalist Daniel, this is Shilpa Nair, and why not find it today? We're just 1 or 2 kilometers away from the landslide site in Wayanad, and we're reporting currently from outside a grocery store that is there here. And what caught our eye is this notice that they've put up, and what it essentially says is, from 3rd August to 8th August, whoever resides in this area, permanently, the people who are living here, for them, any food items that they buy from here or any groceries that they buy from here, it will be given for free, free of cost. That is what this particular notice says. Many people have moved off to relief camps. Many of them were taken to hospitals, etc. But there are still people in and around this area who are still living in their houses, who have not been able to move out for whatever reasons. And they've been finding it difficult to get groceries, to go buy, essential items. And that is the reason why they thought, if they can help them out, at least in this way, let us do that. And that is the reason why they've put up this board that, up until 8th of August, people living in this area can come and get all that they need from this shop free of cost. So, and this just goes on to show how people of Kerala are empathetic, and they completely understand that Wayanad needs a helping hand, and that's precisely what they're extending. With video journalist Daniel, this is Shilpa Nair in Wayanad for India Today. Although nothing can replace the comfort that they would get at their own homes for the Wayanad landslide victims, the state government of Kerala, different volunteer groups, different private groups, and in fact the people of Kerala are extending the much-needed helping hand. We are currently reporting from one of the relief camps that have been opened at Mapudi. In fact, this is one of the biggest relief camps that have been opened. It's situated a couple of kilometers away from where the landslide took place. And what you see essentially here is all these classrooms are being used for different purposes. One to collect relief materials, one to segregate relief materials, one to offer health camps, one to offer counseling sessions to these victims, etc. And at the entrance you see a couple of help desks that have been put out, and this is the help desk of one of the private mobile networks where they help these survivors get a duplicate SIM card with the help of their Aadhaar card number. And this another one here is the help desk put out by the SBI. This is a mobile ATM that they have put out where people can come and they just need to give them their phone numbers, and they will figure out their Aadhaar card number and whichever bank account it is, they help them withdraw money. These are all people who've come all the way from Kerala. They have a kitchen right here where food is prepared, and you can see how that is also served at this main dining area. And apart from that, again, if you just pan a bit and show, there's a mobile health services van that has been placed here. This belongs to a very leading healthcare group in Kerala, a private group, and they are offering healthcare services. And if you also notice, most of them are wearing masks because that has been mandated by the health department of Kerala, because there could be spread of contagious diseases. So to prevent that, the health department has mandated that everyone should wear a face mask. So these are some of the arrangements that have been put in place here at the relief camps, not just here but across the relief camps in different parts of Wayanad. And at this point in time, like I said, nothing can replace the comfort of their homes. And the Chief Minister himself, Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan, said that it's not like these people can stay at these camps for a long time. This is just a temporary arrangement. But up until then, the government wants to ensure that the best of facilities are extended to these people who are undergoing one of the most difficult phases of their lives. With video journalist Daniel, this is Shilpa Nair in Wayanad for India Today.
Officially itself, as per enquiries itself, it is more than 200 people. But you see, there are a lot of people from other states. Last 2 days, we were able to recover large number of bodies. Still, some of the areas has to be excavated more. Today, probably we are, since there are more machinery, we will be able to dug and see that whether more and more areas has been explored. And we are trying to get more bodies. We cannot stop the search until and unless the entire, all the six souls has been totally searched.
Shibi Mohl is getting us more details on that big story that she's tracking very, very closely. Shibi, in fact, we've been putting out your reports in here. We just heard from an official who said that we can't wrap up the rescue work just yet because there is hope amidst hope that there could be more people, there could be more survivors. And how can we just not factor that in? Because after all, at the end of the day, we saw that miraculous rescue today as well when the six children were rescued, isn't it? I was talking about that miraculous rescue and pictures of the same on his screens right now. Six tribal children were rescued by forest officials as seen in these pictures. And nothing short of a miracle here. These beautiful pictures coming in of this rescue operation speaking volumes of the dedication and integrity of the forest officials. Authorities say that the rescue work will continue until the time they're sure that every possible survivor is in fact rescued. And even if there aren't survivors, they respectfully want that the bodies be in fact taken away from the taken out from the debris and the slush there, and that really is their objective. Shibi, the authorities there indicating that the rescue operations will continue because they want to in fact try and see if there are more survivors, or even if there are just people who've succumbed or there are casualties, they want to respectfully retrieve the bodies and hand it over to the family members, isn't it?
Well, exactly, Sneha, because that's what clearly since morning the officials have been telling, that there is no clarity as to when the rescue operations will get over. ADGP Law and Order informed that whenever there's logically possible, that the rescue operations can be completed is the only time we are going to stop this. This is going to continue. We have divided the teams into six zones with five teams focusing on land and one team in the water, because a lot of bodies were recovered from what even today morning a body was recovered from the Chaliyar River in Nilambur in Malappuram. So that's the focus right now. Everywhere, every nook and corner of Churulmala and Mundakkai, wherever is humanly possible, they have been taking these machines and trying to recover as many bodies as possible, as what we are being told. The district administration, what ADGP told us is that as per the district administration, they have received around 400 missing complaints as of now. The official data shows 205 people still missing, but the complaints that they have received are around 400. So that means a lot more people are still missing. But again, practically speaking, there is when we visited the site, it's very evident that it's not really possible to recover all these bodies because the length, the feet of the debris is that huge that it's not very easy for them to, you know, recover all of it. Possibly it will end up as missing cases after a few days or few weeks. So that's what we've seen in the past in one of the landslides that took place in Idukki a few years ago. Five people are still missing because a landslide of this magnitude, it's become even more difficult to keep a record of, you know, to recover these many bodies.
Absolutely. I'm going to thank you, Shibi, for the moment for getting us up to speed with those details. Shibi Mohl on Ground Zero, putting that story into perspective for our viewers.